great start of the Kara Actuation arc. My boy. This is a good episode. I really liked it, but there was some stuff like, really? They actually have to censor this bit when they didn't censor the Shin Uchiha arc at all, and they've even censored that bit right there. But let's get straight on the video. Yo, what's up guys, and welcome back to a brand new YouTube video. And today, in this video, we are reviewing episode 157 of Boruto Naruto Next Generation. This is the start of the Kara Actuation arc in the anime, and the Kawaki arc is still happening in the manga. The Kawaki arc still needs to end in the manga, then the anime can adapt that scene into anime though, because if they're gonna like change the ending or and that, or they like gonna do like original like a they can still do the like the anime is gonna like catch up to the Kawaki arc, and then what's it, the Kishimoto, the fucking creator of Boruto, has to like give the details about the ending. This is gonna happen in the manga when the chapter comes out, and you need to input this in the anime, and people's gonna get confused, and I'm like, oh, now I have to really read this chapter when the anime happened already, like, oh my god. But I just get enough of this fucking talk. There is some good moments in this anime, like you see the Hidden Rain again, and that was quite good. Like, I remember the Hidden Rain was a very dark place till this day. Like, you see when it was like destroyed, there was not many towers left. Like, when you see in back in Naruto, there's like, it's a massive city. Now it's like a rubble city, there's like a like few towers left, and when the base, the Kara base erupted, whole city erupted. Now it's like a massive wasteland. I swear no one lives there anymore. I swear like they all moved or they all went. It's like Hidden Rain's like, or like a base of operations or something like that. We see Kara in the flashbacks and throughout the Hidden Rain from Gran Tanisio, that guy who everyone thought, and I thought was that he was a Maki, like a nook, because he was pretty linked to Pain and that shit, but it wasn't. he was just an outer member of Kara, anime original, but he got killed off straight away. He was being used, to be honest. Like, every single outer member is being used, like scientific, ninjas, fucking. There's a guy, I would say, because of a spoiler. It's gonna be a massive spoiler, but you know who. It's from the manga, if you who reads the manga and all of that. But it was a really, really good episode, too. It's a good start to the Kara Actuation arc. There is some like manga material I can wait to be released, but next episode looks okay, to be honest. If they do it right, I'd be good. They have using that guy with the scarf and the glasses a lot, because we know all what happens in the manga about that guy. We all know what happens, but yeah, that is just like, it's just finding like about a missing person, and then you see this guy at the end of the preview, and my boy, oh boy, I can't wait for that guy, because we know who the hell is. You're probably gonna just like match with him. Like, if you look at the Kara and you see the guy who smirks, you know who's that guy in the preview is. It is a Kara member right there. But like, we see Kara right there, and you say, you know, like the last panel of Mugina Bandits arc, that's meant to be adapted in the last panel of the Mugina Bandit arc in the anime. But it's just a good moment, to be honest. A good start. I thought it'd be like after, like they're gonna like adapt that scene of the Kara from the Mugina Bandits arc in the anime to like the last bit of the extended part of the anime, but yeah, it wasn't, to be honest. But there is some scene that I like, oh my god, I can't believe they censored this. And then actually, it wasn't like they didn't put off screen or done a different angle. They actually put a black screen like usually every anime who from Crunchyroll or Funimation will blame and censor off. And they actually censor it. That's been, if I get the flipping anime in Blu-ray, like maybe like box set 9, 10, 11, whatever, of course, it's only like up to box set 4 over here in the UK. I hope it's not censored that bit there, because I want to see the guy who blimmin' killed himself, because this arc is much more violent and serious and dark tone. So I hope they don't censor most of these scenes in the future of the anime, because they need this silent shit to make this Kara arc more seen. We didn't see much of Kara really, we just see like the flashbacks of the Hidden Rain base and that, and the time to begin scene in the end of the Mujin Abandoned arc in the manga and that. But yeah, it was a good episode. You see Saya and Sasuke working together, like Bashin Tanjo thinks he killed them, but it was just like shedding clones in the poison. It's like, it was a really good episode, to be honest. I really liked it, but see what episode 158 looks like. I know I read the spoilers and that. 158 and 159 are just like search and rescue episodes. Episode 60 is an intel episode, and that's all we know so far. But I hope it's like the next few episodes are good. I think there's gonna be like maybe like 10 or 15 anime original shit, and then we're gonna get to the proper manga shit, and I can't wait for that. Especially people that anime only fans, you are in for a treat with this Kara arc. In for a fucking treat. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure you smash the like button. Can we get 5 likes on this video? Also, follow my social, my links in the description down below, my Instagram, my Twitter. Also, join my Discord server as well. And see you in the next video. Peace out.